Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I look a bit crazier than usual. I am going to show you how I straighten my hair. This top part over here is my natural hair. It is very wavy right now. Naturally, it is, as it grows out, it gets spirally. The top of my head, it's weighed down because of the rest of the hair. So right now it's just kind of like weird little waves. It's kind of hard to tell, but you can kind of see it's like super curly. But as it grows out, it gets really tight spirals. I'll put a picture on the screen. That is my natural hair and my natural hair color. This dark brown is not. So some quick background. My hair, I get the permanent Japanese hair straightening, which makes my hair permanently super straight and smooth. My hair is really puffy right now, and that's because I was an idiot. And I decided that straight hair wasn't enough. No, I wanted to go blonde. I wanted to go slight, like a bit lighter. Like I wanted like a medium blonde. I don't know if that makes any sense. But my hair, because it is naturally lighter, it bleached really quickly and it basically turned white. It really damaged my hair. And once I dyed it back to brown, which took forever to get it to actually stick, this dark brown color, I started to get my Japanese hair straightening again, and they could not do it on top of the hair that had been bleached. So there's like an awkward section like that long here that grew in the 8 months that I was blonde that is just extremely puffy, damaged feeling. A lot of my hair actually broke off. If you see these pieces, this is where the blonde was, and now it's grown in. It's only at my shoulders when the rest of my hair is like, you can see, like this is how much has grown in since I stopped dyeing my hair blonde. The rest of my hair that wasn't blonde, this all got super damaged from being blonde, so it's no longer nice and silky smooth. But just getting the Japanese hair straightening on my natural virgin hair, it is extremely smooth and perfectly straight and how I love it. So now I'm forced to straighten my whole hair, not just the roots. So that's what this video is about. I am actually going to be doing a first impressions on the Eeza Professional hair straightener, and this is the digital Mirror Titanium Flat Iron. It looks like this, and they did find me on Instagram and offered to send me this for a review or like to take pictures. They didn't request a video, but I wanted to do a how I straighten my hair video because I keep thinking that everyone knows what my natural hair is like, and then people are really surprised when I say it's curly and they're like, what do you mean? When I had curly hair, I needed to wake up at 5:30 every single day to wash it and brush it because I cannot brush my hair. It ends up just being like a fluffy mess of like soft fluffiness. Like it looks like a soft afro. It wouldn't become an actual afro because my hair isn't that like thick, wiry, I guess, feeling. I don't know how to say this without offending people because people get so offended nowadays. Basically, African hair and my hair are not at all the same texture. And a lot of people assume that it is, but it's not. The strainer that I was using, it does make my hair a tiny bit staticky, but it only started doing that once I used the hair dye that I did on my hair. This on its own never made it staticky. So I'm curious to see if this one won't be staticky. I'm also going to maybe try and do like a slight wave or a slight big curl with this because it is shaped really thin, and I saw on their Instagram, which is linked down below, that a lot of people were using this to do big curls. So I will explain my thoughts as I go. Okay, so the straightener is now on. It's starting to heat up. It is digital screen, which is pretty cool. I guess that's what they meant by digital. It's like 289, 295, 300. It's heating up really fast, which is really nice. There's just like the three buttons on the side for off, hotter and colder. I just do sections. I don't measure them or anything, and you can kind of see there a better representation of my hair. So I just use my tangle teaser to brush it out, and I'm ready to start. I'm gonna grab tiny part by part and clip this right over here. So now that that's all good, you can definitely feel that it's hot. I go over this top part a bunch of times, and then I just slide it through. Go pretty slow. I brush through again, but this time, as I hold the hair, oh, this is so hard to do in a viewfinder compared to a mirror. And yeah, I'm looking in the viewfinder. I have no mirror in front of me at all to do my hair. So that's all I do. It works. I don't know what I was expecting. It seems to work just fine. I'm impressed at how fast it heat up, to be honest. Nothing feels like it's burning, like nothing smells like it's burning, which is nice. The reason that I get the Japanese permanent hair straightening done is because my natural hair doesn't actually straighten to look like I have naturally straight hair. It needs to have all those chemicals in it to force it to be straight. So I have the one section done. That's what it looks like. My hair is like dead, obviously, at the very bottoms. But it's nice and straight compared to this side. Okay, so I did a whole other section of my hair. And so this is now one side. It's actually a lot quicker when I'm not trying to show you guys and worrying if I'm in frame. Look how much hair I have. This is just that little section. I have a lot of freaking hair. It's kind of crazy. And I know a lot of you are gonna be like, you're so lucky you have a lot of hair. It doesn't feel lucky when you have to straighten it every time you wash it. And it just takes forever. It takes me about 45 minutes to an hour to straighten my hair every week. I actually forgot to attempt using this. So I'll do that for the next section. Fits perfectly. I like the glove. It's nice to be able to grab on and not burn my finger. The only reason I don't like these gloves is because my hands sweat when I use them. And my hands normally don't sweat. I also can't feel if there are any bumps. Like up here there are bumps. Yeah, like I can't feel at all if I miss a spot with the gloves on. But for just doing like the quick pass-throughs, it's totally fine. But I'm really liking the straightener. It's really quick. And so far I'm not seeing any static, so I'm pretty happy about that. I might just try and do like a big curl right now and see what happens. I'm not good at like curling my hair, so I don't know exactly if this is how it works. Oh shit. Oh! That's actually really cute. Do you see that? Okay, so it does work for that. I'm gonna go back to straight though. So yeah, this easily curls your hair, even for people that suck at it, like I do. I really like this. I am back with the final look. The quality is gonna be a bit off because now it's a bit too dark and I can't get the exposure to go up any higher because it's just like low quality now. So this is my hair.
What my hair looks like on the scalp. This is the hardest part to straighten, but I'm pretty sure I got it all pretty good.
And I have been using something to grow my hair faster, but that's something I'll be talking to you about in June when I'm done testing it out, kind of like the first part of it. Overall, first impression on the straightener, I like it. This worked pretty quickly. It was good. I don't know how much I can say about a straightener. It didn't change my life. It's not like it's going to make my hair permanently straight. If it can they invent a straightener that does that, that'd be amazing. It's really lightweight. I like that it has the actual digital thing on the screen saying the temperature that it is and if it's off. As soon as you plug it in, it'll say off, and then you have to actually click the on button and whatnot. I'm not sure if there's a timer on this because it turned off. I may have accidentally hit it because I was holding it like this and I may have hit my thumb on it. If you have this, you probably don't need a curling iron as well, unless you want to do like a really specific look. But you saw from like the one curl that I did that it was great. So yeah, this is my hair. The ends are fried, as I have said. That's my hair. It's like down to my waist. Like just where my waist is. As for the glove, do I think this is necessary? No, it comes with the box though, so it's not like you would have to buy it separately. It's nice if you're going really quick to try and like do your hair really fast, especially if your hair is already straight and you just want to make it sleek. This is great. You won't burn your hair if you're quickly going through it. For my hair, I need to go through it quickly and then go in and make sure the very tops are perfectly straightened because I can't feel if it's a bit kinky through the glove. They have other cool products on their website. Like they have one of those straightening brushes, which I'm very curious about the straightening brushes. I've never used one before. The mitt itself is $12.99. I don't think you need that if you were just thinking about getting a mitt for straightening your hair. If you are doing a curling iron, like a curling wand, for sure. Right now on the website, there's a sale on this straightener. It is this one right here. It is the Isa Professional Digital Titanium Flat Iron Straightener. And it is right now selling for $129. So pretty pretty average price for a good straightener. The straightener that I was using, the pink one that I showed you, that one was in like the 200 and something dollar zone. It is a bit up there, so if you are gonna buy the straightener, definitely get it now, or if it goes on sale again, I don't have a discount code. Straightening brush is $98. Right now I'm a bit poor, so I can't buy it. So free shipping USA, free shipping international. That's nice. And it comes with a 2-year warranty as well. So if it just stops working, if it breaks, whatever, fill out the little form and send it to them. So yeah, that is it for this video. Thank you so much, Isa, ISA, professional. I really need to start asking companies how to pronounce their names. But thank you for reaching out to me and sending me the straightener. Hopefully this video was good to show everyone how I straighten my hair. It is a long process and I probably talk way too much, and editing this down is going to be a bitch. So let me know if you know the difference between a flat iron and a hair straightener. Check out their Instagram. Like I said, I'll link down the website and their Instagram down below, and I'll probably post a picture pretty soon with the straightening iron with like, and tagging them on Instagram, but just in case, I'll put it down there. So give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, or if it was somewhat informational, even if it's just like you had no idea that I had curly hair and what I do to it. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.